Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of their lives, وَالْعِيَدُ بِاللَّهِ, you see they ended up, they were sealed, their life were taken in something that is haram, in a bad deed. Of course, we still don't know that they're going to hellfire or Jannah. We don't know, we cannot judge. Still, we have to pray for them. We have to pray for them for a rahmah, and we have to pray for them for a maghfirah. It doesn't matter how they die. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that will judge them. That's why we don't judge nobody, even though somebody was saying that Umm Kulthum, this famous Egyptian singer, I guess she was in the 70s and 80s or somewhere around there, and he was telling him, Umm Kulthum, rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on her. And the man turned around to him and he says, why you're asking Allah to have mercy on her? She was a singer. She was in cabarets, she was in drinking places, you know. Why would you ask a rahim for her? And then the other brother told him, what do you want me to do? Ask a rahma for Umar ibn Khattab, for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Those we don't ask a rahma for them. We say, radiyallahu anhum, those are sealed and they are going to a Jannah. Who is a rahma for? A rahma is for us, for everybody. Everybody that says, La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, ask Allah for rahmah. It doesn't matter how bad it seems they were doing in this life, only Allah knows what's hidden. For us, we have to think good of our brothers and sisters. We have to. We are ordered to. Always a good thinking. You don't judge people. Why? Because we might be ending up in the same way that they ended up. If we think we're better, and only one person that thinks that was better than Adam is a shaitan. We do not think that we are better than the next person. And as we know, this deen, it's a vast garden surrounded with walls or whatever you want to call it. It has all kinds of trees. There is mango trees, there is apple trees, there is prune trees, there is all kind of, not only the tree. I'm not the only one in here. It doesn't mean my Islam is the only Islam. And that's what some people think. They think that they are the only one that's going to Al-Jannah. And as you know, we saw in videos, people that are coming, I'm not saying you shouldn't have a beard, but people with no beard, and they're dressed with normal clothes, Western clothes, and they made sajda and they died in sujood in a masjid. That's for us is what? Is husn khatim. Husn khatim. We have to think that we are not the only one in here that have the good deen and we're doing what's good and we're the only one going. And some people have that in their mind, subhanAllah, and it hurts. It hurts when you see people judging others and subhanAllah saying bad things about the other Muslims. And we are all the same, we are all inshallah gonna end up in the same place. So we're gonna have to get used to each other. We have to get used to each other. We all inshallah gonna finish in the same place, which is the Jannah, inshallah, ameen. So, whoever have tawfiq, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the good deed at the end of his life, Allah has written for him husn khatima. Allah has given him that good ending. And whoever, subhanAllah, who said that he has that bad intentions inside his heart, but he's showing to the others that he's a good man and all that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's gonna be mad at him. يغضب الله عليه, and he will end up with سوء الخاتمة. سوء الخاتمة, and we have stories for that. Subhanallah, that people that were mashallah in the deen and coming to the masjid at all time, and at the end of their life, subhanallah, they went the other way and died. والعياذ بالله. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said that I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, the hearts of Ben Adam, the heart of the son of Adam, are between the fingers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they're all like one heart. All of our hearts is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He changed them, or He exchanged them, or he guides them any way He wants. So Allah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He said to us, now make this dua, Ya musarrif al-qulub, sarrif qalbi ala deenik. Oh, the one that changes the hearts, make my heart steadfast on your deen. And that's one of the things that we are asked to make dua for. We have to make dua three things every single time. We have to make a dua for our parents. If they're dead, we have to make the dua for our parents. That's from Ridha al-Walidain. We make dua. Number two is we ask Husn al-Khatima. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the good ending in every salah. And then we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us stability in this deen. To give us stability in this deen. This is the three that we need to be asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ.